A self-sustaining aquarium is designed to mimic the balance found in natural water bodies, where plants, microorganisms, and animals interact to maintain water quality and biological stability without heavy reliance on artificial filtration, fertilizers, or frequent water changes. In an ecosystem, all elements are interconnected and work systematically. The tank you see has survived and continued to thrive for over a year without any filters, CO2 injection, additional fertilizers, or water changes. Because throughout this process, the ecosystem fertilized itself, filtered itself, and continues to sustain itself. I want to start with the base. At the very bottom of the tank, there is organic garden soil. Using dirt in an aquarium ecosystem has many benefits, especially for creating a self-sustaining and plant-friendly environment. Soil is rich in essential nutrients such as nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and trace minerals. These nutrients support healthy plant growth. Plants with roots growing in the soil absorb these nutrients directly, promoting strong root development. The organic matter in garden soil decomposes over time, slowly releasing nutrients into the water column. This mimics natural environments, where decaying matter provides a constant source of nutrients. When capped with sand or gravel, soil particles are prevented from clouding the water, while plant roots continue to access the nutrients. Soil provides a porous environment for beneficial bacteria to colonize, supporting biological filtration. These bacteria break down ammonia and nitrites, helping to maintain balanced water quality. When selecting soil, it's very important to choose completely organic, pesticide-free, fine-grained soil and cover it with a thick layer of sand. Another very important component for creating a self-sustaining ecosystem is plants. Plants release oxygen into the water through photosynthesis, which is essential for the survival of fish and other aquatic organisms. This natural oxygenation helps maintain healthy water quality and supports a thriving ecosystem. Plants absorb excess nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus from the water, which prevents algae overgrowth. This helps keep the water clear and balanced, reducing the need for artificial chemicals or frequent water changes. Plants act as natural filters by removing waste products, organic matter, and harmful substances from the water. They help in maintaining water quality by breaking down organic material, reducing ammonia and nitrite levels. Through photosynthesis, plants absorb carbon dioxide from the water and convert it into oxygen. This helps regulate CO2 levels, keeping the water pH stable and supporting fish and plant health. The presence of plants helps create a stable ecosystem by balancing nutrient levels, oxygen production, and waste breakdown. They contribute to a low-maintenance, self-sustaining environment by ensuring the proper functioning of the ecosystem's various elements. I talked about the substrate and plants, but fish are also part of the ecosystem. Fish can be both beneficial and sometimes harmful to the ecosystem. Their benefits and harms are entirely in our hands. First, I want to talk about their benefits. Fish produce waste in the form of ammonia, which is broken down by beneficial bacteria in the biological filtration process. This waste also serves as a natural fertilizer for plants, promoting their growth. They help maintain the balance of nutrient cycles in the ecosystem by contributing to the decomposition of organic matter. Fish are a key part of the food chain. Herbivores feed on plants and algae, and carnivores feed on invertebrates. This supports a balanced ecosystem by regulating populations and promoting biodiversity. Due to some mistakes we make, fish can indirectly become harmful to the ecosystem. Excessive fish waste can lead to water quality issues if not properly managed. High levels of ammonia, nitrites, and nitrates can harm plants and other organisms. Overfeeding fish can result in uneaten food decaying, further deteriorating water quality. If there are too many fish in the aquarium, their waste production may outpace the ability of plants. This can cause an imbalance, leading to nutrient overload and poor water quality. Some fish, especially those in large numbers, may consume large amounts of oxygen, reducing the oxygen levels in the water. This can harm plants, invertebrates, and other fish that rely on oxygen to survive. Fish are vital for a balanced aquarium ecosystem, but their impact must be carefully managed. Proper fish stocking, monitoring waste production, and ensuring balanced nutrient cycles are key to preventing negative impacts. When managed correctly, fish contribute to a thriving and self-sustaining ecosystem. I want to talk about zooplankton, which are among the most important elements for ecosystems, yet are rarely mentioned in aquarium topics and are mostly unnoticed by the naked eye. Zooplankton serve as a food source for many aquarium inhabitants, especially for smaller fish, shrimp, and fry. They provide essential nutrients like proteins and fatty acids that help support healthy growth and development. They feed on algae, bacteria, and detritus in the water, helping to control excess nutrients. By grazing on these materials, they help maintain water quality and prevent the growth of harmful algae blooms. If there are enough stones, rocks, plants, and botanicals in the aquarium, zooplankton will hide and breed in these areas, creating an endless food web for the fish. To introduce them to your tank, you can add some water and botanicals from the edge of a water body. If you don't want to do that, they will form in your tank over time. However, this is not something that happens quickly. It takes months for them to develop. It's very important to learn these key concepts and apply them correctly to create a self-sustaining ecosystem. Even though the system may be self-sufficient, we may still need to perform some maintenance. For example, I regularly clean the front glass of this tank, or occasionally change the positions of the plants when necessary. I also feed the fish regularly, though there have been times when I didn't feed them for long periods. Finally, I want to talk about algae. If your tank has a lot of plants, few fish, your lighting is not too strong, and the light duration is not too long, the likelihood of seeing algae in your tank is quite low. Overfeeding the fish can lead to algae growth. I keep this tank light on for 8 hours a day. If you're experiencing unwanted algae growth in your tank, reduce the lighting time to a minimum and feed the fish at a minimum level. Over time, you will notice that algae formation slows down. It's also important to remember that algae are a part of the ecosystem, and there will always be some algae in every tank, even if it's very little. I hope this video has been helpful for those who want to create a self-sustaining ecosystem tank. As always, thank you for watching my video and for your support. Subscribing would make me happy. We've had a great year with this tank, but now it's time for something different. See you soon. Peace and love.